I yeah, I am again with my do-it-yourself pseudo-synthic, and I thought about talking about how I organized my workspace. This thing is good for what I do, which is almost incredibly line art work with the black inks on white. Why almost incredibly? Simply because it is not bad. But if you can see, the pen is not steady. The screen over the tablet adds some noise. Now, how is it possible to use a faulty, because if I had bought it, I would have returned it. How it is possible to use a faulty unit to make good work, because I make good work. In reality, it's not that this thing is faulty, it's simply that I don't have a specific driver that can address its shortcomings. When you buy a Wacom Cintiq, its screen does interfere a bit with the tablet anyway. Probably it is something in the range of this one. This thing actually moves the cursor something less than one pixel, maybe every 2 seconds. It is an Intuos 2 A5, which is 6 inches by 8 inches really, with on top the same type of screen used in the iPad 1. This screen comes from a scrapped Arnova G20, and it was much cheaper than a replacement screen for an iPad. It's always still an LP097X02 SLEA, but it I paid $20 with shipping for it and not $100, which for me is a plus. Also, the tablet below is also obviously second hand. It was $20 that too. I should return this maybe, because it seems that I have some offset. Well, it happens. Now, but its purpose is to select to allow fine selections, which is not so easy when with the things that are in the wiggly area of this one. This is the worst position. Then when it starts the drawing area, more or less it goes down to one pixel, which is livable. Now, to obviate these interferences, the drivers for the real thing, what they simply do is use a trick, some mathematical trick, to filter out the noise. The simplest one to understand is the average wind, the moving average window. That is pretty simple. Yes. I changed the one of the key. Okay. It's pretty simple. Let's say that the pen produces five values that change in time, which are the position y, the pressure, often called axis z, and the tilt on the two sides. Now, okay. Let's say that this is the time. This is one of the five values. Let's say position on the its axis, and I am simply keeping the pen steady. Ideally, what you should say is this, a steady value. What it happens when the pen wiggle is that the value of this changes, and what really arrives from the tablet is something like this, or let's be a bit more exaggerated, because something like this. Now, moving average window, what it does is simply take the values in a window, and at the end give up the average. Now, the average of this part is always it's a needle. So let's say that the window then moves on, and at the end it gives you the average out value. So let's say that in the front is the original raw data from the digitzer. In output you have a smoothed out curve of some kind. What is the problem with this system, and in reality with every possible system to fix the issue, that this is time zero current. You need to have some values and you pop out. This is the response from the pen that it sees, it sees from the rest of the universe, and it comes after a delay. The stronger the stabilization, the larger the delay, the laggier it feels the pen. So, drivers often have some internal tricks to try to do it the best possible way with the littlest the possible delay. Probably I think that they also analyze that the noisiness of the signal to switch it on and off automatically. If they does so, the same unit on a different computer may behave in different form, which is, by the way, something that I already heard. But this is more or less a basic system. Another one is instead of using a moving average, using a geometric average that is similar but a bit different on the mechanical on the mechanics of the on its behavior. I like the moving average because I understand it well. Now, Some most drawing computer, the drawing programs that has been designed after the tablets became widespread, have some kind of feature that implements this. This program is on the studio, and it's called stabilization. Manga Studio has a level that goes from 0 to 15, which is probably more than enough with a well-functioning machine or a simple or a pure digitizer like an Intuos without anything on top. For me, it's a bit little and not enough. Also, I arrived to Manga Studio after a while. I started with Photoshop. Photoshop has no trace of this. It has no stabilization whatsoever, no stroke smoothing, nothing. Whatever arrives from the digitzer or the operating system that passes as digitzer, it goes on to become the input for the drawing area. No stabilization, no interpolation, nothing. It is a, if you do draw inks, it is a crappy program, Photoshop, to use. Very good for other things, but for doing this, absolutely not. Now, as I said, I started with using only Photoshop, and I had a problem with this. At the time, I had a less noisy machine, based upon an Intuos 4, but the screen was so-so, and I didn't know at the time, but also the pen was so-so. One of the reasons I decided to stick with the Intuos 2 till I can is this pen. And this pen, they are both much better to use than the Intuos 4s, which, by the way, for all I know, are some of the same that are used for the Intuos 5, the Intuos Pro, and whatever else after. The 2048 pressure levels are useless pen. Nothing more to say. So let's take this away. As I said, I am in the business of do this kind of drawings, more or less, and usually a lot more precise than this. I make my machine usable using a third-party stroke smoother called Lazy-Nezumi. That is this program, Lazy-Nezumi Pro. The guy charges quite a buck for this, $40 for 2 years of support, something like this. For me, it's the money well spent. Among the other things, because even this pen hasn't the kind of pressure response that I like, but Lazy-Nezumi allows you to literally draw the response curve that you want from your pen. Only problem, it is nice, it doesn't work so well with Intuos 4, because the Intuos 4 pen, after 5 minutes that you use it, changes response. When I don't know how it works its sensor, it warms up, to say so, and it suddenly becomes even more of a feeder weight than it is at the start. The Intuos 2 at least is consistent. It keeps the same value from moment 1 to 16 hours after. So I tweaked my pressure response curve, in so that the first 25% of pen input gives me a 5% output, because this 25% comes out with 5% output of your of my pen, of my end pressure, and with this like this, it was more or less right. By the way, if you see, I saturate the output at 75%. This means that in reality I don't even use all the 1024 pressure levels that are the precision of this pen. I use less than 7368, something like that. Doesn't matter. It works for what I need to do. This Izumi Pro with time has grown with more bells and whistles. Personally, I use it with a set of presets that I designed, so that each one was more or less stabilizing than the next, and I switch between one and the other using two keys in this fancy numeric pad. I have a macros program called DidMacros that recognizes the input from each different keyboard and mouses also. And so, if you can see, pop, change. Here I use moving average. The other possibility is pull string or exponential moving average. Each one has its pros and cons. Moving average is simply the one that I understand the best. And also I set the colors of the overlay so that it goes from red for no stabilization to to green for stabilized values. So as you see, yellow my average, I'm going down. Red, virtual no stabilization, virtually no stabilization, but still control on the pressure. And this is I really switched it off, so I have no stabilization control. Now, stabilization is very useful because it allows to overcome the noisiness of the screen. If by chance you have bought the Innova or Union or something, and you aren't happy of their driver's stabilization, remember, you can invest $4, buy Lazy Nezumi, and have it on the fly. Well, this part is a bit complicated, but complicated, not really. I use this program, it macros, and these are all hotkeys. I use a lot of hotkeys. These are more or less selecting the tools from the toolbox in the drawing program. These are other things that I use less frequently, but still quite frequently. For example, the color curves. Or changing the canvas. more or less, if I use something more than once or twice for a drawing, I tend to find a key to a scene. As you can see, I still have plenty of space for future functions. In reality, these are the ones that I remember, the tools in numeric mode. In our non-numeric mode, it is a bit different because this becomes duplicate the layer. This becomes is a bit complicated because it duplicates the layer, inverts its colors, and goes to the layer below. I use it for a trick that I call tubing. Tubing is something like this. Okay, switch on, and there's a nice good level. Whoop. Okay, let's go in a place where we can see the tube. White. And so on till I have a tube, or this is useful with air and other things. It is the reason why more or less I set it up so that I can do it simply on this one. A nice thing of this numeric pad is that it keeps a status separate from that of the rest of the system. As you can see, it is switched on in num mode, but the rest of the system is not. Now it isn't. He doesn't care. It took me a while to understand that what it does is actually switching on and off all the rest when you press the key. So it can be tricky to get it to work correctly with it. No, tricky no. You have to remember. When this and the system are not aligned, the first thing that that pad does is pressing a num lock. So if you use the macros, if you are registering a new macro, you can make the mistake of registering num lock as the macro, and as it does press that key twice every time that is out of sync with the rest of the system, it can become easily very confusing. But once you learn, not a problem. As I said, tubing has its good thing. Another very good thing is most common commands I have placed on this wireless numeric pad, which means, for example, that I can undo like this, undo, redo sizes of the brush, zoom in, zoom out, swap color, swap primary, secondary color, I almost never used the transparent color that Manga Studio has. These three are the commands for the stabilization, for the stroke smoother, or cuts. And what more? No, not nothing really. And yes, more or less. It covers the basics. So before this thing out that you didn't buy a 2300 bucks Cintiq, take your time a bit to think about how you can get the best from the machines that you have attended. It takes a bit of ingenuity, but not very much. With LNP, you can have stroke by stroke selectable smoothing, and you can literally draw whatever you want. You can you can draw a smoothing flowing line like this, or take it down to draw something more frenzied, or some intermediate level, still fast but not too controlled. It's a bit difficult. If you look at the stickers that I placed on the keys, you can see at the frequency of use of each one. As you can see, the sizes are more or less very scraped. I use a ton zoom in, zoom out. I use very often swap colors. A lot less often than I thought, undo and literally never redo. Redo is this one, it's practically new. I use quite often the two selections for the levels of the stroke smoothener. A little more on-off, because often I go from on to off, and nothing more. So, before going out, this is $10. If you don't feel so confident in fiddling with settings and etc., you can always buy programmable gamepads or something like that. They will ask you a bit more money, but maybe if you spend less time fiddling with hardware and drawing, it's better. But anyway, it's very useful. Okay, I don't have anything more to say. Ciao!